that time again. Somebody's going back to school today, and it's not me, but...
Nah, 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 nah.
Is that how it's going to be?
Yeah.
I always loved the first day of school because I grew up on the farm.
Oh, yeah, so that was exciting for you to get out of the summer and go back and see real people.
Yeah. I talked to kids today, and they're like moping.
Yeah, you were outstanding in your field.
I was. I was into broadcasting, but it was mostly fertilizer before I got into the radio game.
There you go.
That's something that we have in common with the big cheese here at Lucky Dog Television Productions.
I particularly didn't care much for school. I went to a tough school, buddy. You know, they always send us little mimeographed things. It's got the school menus on
it. Well, that was the cool thing about
stuff.
A test.
We had no obituary in ours. It was insanity. Yeah, it was wild, man.
I used to love
test. You like that? I remember that. Yeah, you can smell that ink.
It was great.
It explains
a lot. Hey, our show's brought to you by HTC, Anderson Brothers Bank, Conway Medical Center, and Beverly Homes. Let's find out what's coming up on the show today other than back to school time with Andrew.
Hey, Jack and Deacon, how are y'all doing?
Man, a little enthusiasm. It's Monday. Rise and shine. Wipe the cobwebs from your eyes. He's acting like a snowflake today.
He's bored. Oh,
good morning.
Try to wake up the best I can. But speaking of back to school, today we have a really great show. Ken Richardson, actually, will stop by a little bit later. Speaking of school, Horry County School Board Chairman.
All righty.
So that'll be get to see what's been going on behind the scenes, preparing for the day of all days.
Right.
After that, keep the Horry County theme going along. We'll speak with Johnny Gardner. I think, things have been a little down lately, but try to boost some morale. Maybe we'll try to do some of that around the studio here with a little feature we like to call Crack a Smile. I'll give you a hint. This one has to do a little conga move.
I don't want to throw anything out of whack.
Yeah, really.
Yeah. So that's all we got today?
That is all we have for today.
Man, he is laid back today.
He is.
Were we too rough
back.
On him last week?
I guess so.
He's awfully reserved.
Who put Valium in your milk?
That's exactly what I'm thinking. Well, maybe something will perk him up. Maybe there's something fun to do. What are we going to talk about from our good friends at Coastal Carolina Remediation? Put on the hard hat, Deacon.
Oh, the old hard hat, buddy. Yeah, you always need a hard hat when you go out and attempt to have a good time. All right, hey, this is the first day of school. A good way to get rid of those little rug rats, at least for, 9 months? Something like that.
They haven't been out of school that long.
No, they go to school 8 months. You get rid of them that long.
Yeah, but they'll get a break for Labor Day here in a few days.
And that's right. Yeah,
then you got Columbus Day, and then there's a teacher's work break in there. And
that's right.
Then Thanksgiving. Yeah. Oh, I forgot Veterans Day.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Then Thanksgiving.
Well.
And then winter break because no one wants to say Christmas anymore.
No.
I digress.
The holiday.
We're already up to New Year's now.
It's a happy holiday.
Yeah.
It's the first day of school here in Horry County. And listen, first day of school tips for you parents and students. All right, listen closely. Eat a healthy breakfast so you can use those little minds.
Yes, I've done that.
Number two, know the school pickup system. Bus route schedule is, you might want to add that to it.
Or drop-off schedule, too.
Exactly.
Yeah, because not all kids ride the bus.
Number three, know your teacher's name. That always helps.
Yeah.
I could give a lot of names from my teachers.
Uh-huh.
Number four, don't forget your backpack. And number five, enjoy the moment. I mean, this is a time in your life. You may not appreciate it now, but later on you're going to really be glad, kids, that you went to school.
I wish I were back in school some days.
Oh, man, I had a great time in school. I hated it back then.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought I hated it, but... I had fun. Yeah, met a lot of cool people. You know, matter of fact, just got back from a reunion.
Now you
liked
fifth grade so much, you did it how many times? Three?
Well, I had to. I didn't want to embarrass my daddy. He was in the sixth grade. I mean, I didn't want to graduate and embarrass my pop. Come on.
Yeah. Oh wow.
Yeah.
All got to ride to that middle school graduation in the same car.
Who drove? Well, my daddy. I was too young.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah, Pop at least had his license.
Yeah.
Yeah, as soon as he learned how to read. All right, can I take the helmet off now?
If you want.
Thank you.
Yeah, Coastal Carolina Remediation. Good folks, really good folks.
Paging your sweet daddy Deacon, take off the helmet. All right.
This is going to be a recurring theme.
Yeah,
where did you get
I like
that?
This.
I mean,
this is
yeah,
great.
Those are kind of cool. I'd like to have one around the house.
This is neat. I'm going to go to those Coastal Carolina games, and you're going to hear your daddy.
Yeah, sweet daddy.
You want to use it?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
Yeah. I might take it home, try it out.
Rah, rah, sis, boom, bah. Listen to me, I'll tell you all. Yeah.
You've got a whole line of them, don't you?
Oh, yes, sir, buddy.
Yeah. Listen, well, we learned last week you rhyme.
Well, Uncle Don gave me this. You can blame our producer and director, Uncle Don.
Uncle Don.
Yes, sir.
All right. Yeah, well, from Uncle Don to Howl, let's see what's happening over Palmetto Chevrolet.
What's going on, everybody? Hal Stoniker with Palmetto Chevrolet. Going to show you how to reset a trip monitor on a 2019 Chevrolet Colorado work truck. On a 2019 Chevrolet Colorado work truck, the way to navigate through the driver information center is on the blinker. Where it says menu, you've got three options: trip, vehicle, and eco. On trip, if you go down one time, there's your trip one. The way to reset it is hold the button on the end. Once it resets, it will automatically resume. Come see us at Palmetto Chevrolet today. Thank you.
All righty. So if you're going to find that new road, you'll find that it leads to downtown Conway for that new Chevrolet car or truck. Hey, don't go anywhere. We'll be back with River Talk 2.0 on most of this same channel, most of it, right after this.
Hi, it's Delaney from Moonshadow Studios, and when I don't have my coffee in the morning, I get real depresso. We'll be right back with more River Talk 2.0 after this.
My family keeps me on the go, and as fellow community members, HTC believes friends and neighbors deserve services that keep the day running smoothly. No matter where life takes me, HTC keeps me connected by providing world-class technology to Horry and Georgetown counties. Because you are here, and so are we. HTC, this is life. Connect with it.
Achieve the smile you've always dreamed of with the Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry. Let Dr. Jeff Horowitz and his staff use their expertise to improve your health as well as your smile. From TMJ or bite problems to smile makeovers, implants, gum disease, and even braces and Invisalign, let our team show you the difference of true comprehensive care. Call today to set up an appointment. The Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry, with two locations to serve you better. One in Conway and Murrells Inlet, now accepting new patients.
I'm Johnny Gardner. I was born and raised here in Horry County. I went to Coastal Carolina, and I've been practicing law here for 25 years. I've seen this county grow, new roads, more cars, and unfortunately, more car wrecks. If you or a loved one have been injured in a car wreck, give me a call. It won't cost you anything to see if I can help. You take care of getting better, we'll take care of the rest.
Anderson Oaks has turned out to be a home away from home for my dad.
The staff here treats the patient as well as the family with dignity and respect.
I think that the rates here are reasonable.
They got to go stay somewhere. They need a better place to stay than this one.
And Anderson Oaks is just making me so fond of life in general, and I just can't wait to get up in the morning and say, God, what do you want me to do today?
Hey guys, I'm John Cassidy with Duplicates Inc. and Market Smart, the best printing company in the area. And we're right back to River Talk 2.0.
Hey, welcome back. Yeah, I know, I'm holding the ukulele.
Ukulele.
Yeah, ukulele. That's how it's technically pronounced, I was
told.
Yeah,
but you can play it.
Yeah.
I'm pretty impressed.
Well, I don't know if
I can
play it.
But you play guitar.
I play a little guitar.
Yeah, that's just a shrunken guitar is all that is.
Well, it's got four strings. They're tuned. It's a little different.
A little miniature guitar.
I really respect Don Ho after picking this thing up.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, we might mess around with it in a bit.
Let's do it.
Yeah, but we got this day in history.
Oh, okay. Let's do it. I don't have to wear a hat for that, do I? On this day in history.
Yeah, you were there. August 19th, 1934.
This is Walter Cronkite on this day in history.
I bet Andrew has no idea who Walter Cronkite is.
Oh, no, he wouldn't know.
He wouldn't know. Yeah. Well, let's do this day in history.
And what happened?
38 million Germans, that's a lot of Germans, voted to make Adolf Hitler the official successor to President von Hindenburg. Oh, the Hindenburg.
I would much rather the Hindenburg than the... it's too bad. Yeah,
it's kind of a whole twisted backroom deal and stuff.
But they both became a disaster.
Yeah.
You like that?
I did. All the humanity, I remember, yeah. 1934. That's going back a ways.
That is a long time ago.
And that ultimately, we know how that tremendously changed the world. So there you go.
All right, make this into a kind of a festive little thing now. Let's
you
just
think?
Change. Yeah, we're going to change the whole format and go from Hitler to a hit. Do you know any good hits on that thing?
No, I only know really original stuff.
Well, you were in radio for a while. Just go ahead and hit a lick on that thing, buddy. Let's do it.
Their story was like a fairy tale. Love blossomed in the spring. She got bit by the love bug and he made her his queen.
Love it.
The picture of true love. The envy of their friends. And no one would have guessed that he'd sting her in the end. It used to be. She never getting stung again by that old used to be. You might as well be hibernating, 'cause there'll be no more pollinating.
Oh, yeah.
Fly on away from here, you old used to be. He whispered sweet nothings. She bought all of his lies. And that old love bug turned out to be just a cockroach in disguise. She denied every rumor that the ladybugs had said, until she caught him buzzing round her neighbor's flower bed. It used to be. She never getting stung again by watching RiverTalk TV. You might as well be evacuating, 'cause that bee started exterminating. Fly on away from here, you old used to be. Well, if that didn't make you crack up.
That's great, buddy. Yeah, everybody here.
Ooh,
round of applause.
Yeah, it all used to be.
Yeah.
Somewhat. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good grief.
You've been warned.
Encore, ladies and gentlemen. Encore for Mr. Jack Nanner. Jack, ladies and gentlemen, and his ukulele. Huh? You only heard it here first.
Thank you, boys and girls. Yeah, and now, how about a conga? Check this out. Our crack a smile from Coastal. Let's see. Who is it? The Carolina Center of Advanced Dentistry.
All right. Smile a bit.
Come on, shake your body, baby. Do that conga. I know you can't control yourself any longer. Feel the rhythm of the music getting stronger. Don't you fight it.
Silly dog. Andrew said that's his favorite clip of the week, doing the conga.
I've seen it. I've seen that before. It is kind of cute. I mean, I will have to admit.
You know what else is cute?
What's that?
Having a corn dog and watching someone hit the third turn at Myrtle Beach Speedway.
Oh, yeah.
Unless you're the guy hitting the third turn. Let's see what's going on. Check out this feature from Myrtle Beach Speedway.
Welcome, race fans, to the 26th edition of the Myrtle Beach 400. It's race day!
Well, this is a big race this weekend. Really excited. A bunch of cars are here. Big, fast track.
Everybody you know, puts it at the top of their list of what they want to win.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Thank you.
Check it out. Check it out. Check it out. Check it out.
What I do away from the track, I go to the hotel, we usually go out to eat somewhere, and then we always ride go-karts here. We always go to a go-kart track or Broadway at the beach or something. There's so much to do in Myrtle Beach. You can't really get bored even if you're not at the racetrack.
We look forward to coming to Myrtle Beach. Our wives, our crew guys, everybody comes down. We're able to kind of spend the evenings out in the town, spending money, shopping, and eating at the local restaurants because it's something different. It's a change of pace for us. But during the day, the guys get to come over here and have fun at the Myrtle Beach Speedway.
Coming here and seeing how nice the area is and everything about it, it's really cool. And seeing a great facility of a racetrack around here, too.
I really like to come down here for the food. It's really good at Broadway at the beach. And I like to come down here and race a lot because this track's really cool. And all our series come here, so it's a good deal. I like it a lot.
Coming to have a good time at the end of the year and blow off some steam at the beach and have fun.
Johnny Gardner. I was born and raised here in Horry County. I went to Coastal Carolina, and I've been practicing law here for 25 years. I've seen this county grow, new roads, more cars, and unfortunately more car wrecks. If you or a loved one have been injured in a car wreck, give me a call. It won't cost you anything to see if I can help. You take care of getting better, we'll take care of the rest.
You can be approved.
At Anderson Brothers Bank, your options are endless. With loans starting at $1,000, we can get you approved even if you have a low credit score. Still nervous about applying for a loan? Anderson Brothers Bank ranked third on the Forbes list for in-state banks. So give us a chance to show you how we treat you like family. Anderson Brothers Bank, since 1933.
Achieve the smile you've always dreamed of with the Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry. Let Dr. Jeff Horowitz and his staff use their expertise to improve your health as well as your smile. From TMJ or bite problems to smile makeovers, implants, gum disease, and even braces and Invisalign. Let our team show you the difference of true comprehensive care. Call today to set up an appointment. The Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry, with two locations to serve you better. One in Conway and Murrells Inlet, now accepting new patients.
You wear many hats, and HTC knows what you need to keep the day running smoothly. You're an entertainment coordinator, appointment maker, and business superhero. You're a personal chef, chauffeur extraordinaire, and a trusted protector. No matter where life takes you, HTC keeps you connected by bringing world-class technology right here to Horry and Georgetown counties, because you are here, and so are we. HTC, this is life. Connect with it.
Hi, I'm Joanna from Crafty Rooster. Stop in, try one of our 20 cold brews, and now we're back to RiverTalk 2.0.
Hey, welcome back. I'm Jack, and the next fellow is not. In the spirit of education, we present How to Speak Southern.
I like that.
Yeah,
welcome
put that
back.
Hat on, my friend.
Welcome back. I'm Jack. All right. Are we ready? Let me get into character. All right. I'm going to teach you Northern folks how to speak Southern, because if you're going to settle in down here, you got to speak our lingo, and you better do it right. Our word for today, if you want to write it down, it's all right, if you know how to write. just a joke. A far. Okay, that's a state of combustion, like... Well, for instance, look over there. There's a far. Yeah, like you call the fire department. Well, anyway, that's the word for today. So I just want y'all to know that that's the first word for this week.
A far.
Huh.
The wise men came from afar.
I like that.
I went
Jack.
Biblical
that
on
was
you
quick.
There. That's okay.
That was real quick.
Well, we've learned something today.
That's right.
Let's talk to the guy who's a. I don't know if I'm going to throw all the responsibility of our kids' learning at your feet. I think parents have a little bit to do with that, and the teachers and the kids themselves. But here he is, the superintendent. The chairman.
That's a good man, right?
The big boss man.
Thank you, guys. Yeah. I appreciate it.
Glad Horry County School Board Chairman Ken Richardson. That's got a nice ring to it.
Well, I'm starting to kind of get used to it a little bit. But today, you know, today's a big day. It's the first day of school. And, I'm either the most popular guy in the county right now, or either a lot of mamas cried this morning and hated to see you know, dropping the kids off at school.
Yeah, but maybe that first day of school. And maybe kindergarten, first grade. But by second grade, moms and dads are pretty much happy for those little boogers to get on the bus.
They are. But I tell you, I love my kindergartners and my first graders, because if I want to know what's going on at a school, I go into a first grade class.
They'll throw you under the bus, Deacon.
If I want to know what's on my computer or how to operate it, I go into first grade.
Right,
yeah. Ask them for help.
You can ask a first grader, and they'll tell you anything, and they'll tell you the truth. So it's pretty interesting.
Well, you said you're kind of a hero. You must be with some of the teachers. A while back on the show, we chatted with you on the phone, and you got into decorating some classrooms, getting them ready for the first day of school.
Yeah, that kind of came about kind of strange. I was just thinking about, you know, what I could do one day for the teachers. And I came up with this idea. I said, well, you know, I'll just have a little drawing. You know, I've got in between my Facebook page and my chairman's page, I got about 14,000 people there. So I said, well, you know, I think I'll just have a little drawing. And if I draw, I'm going to draw out five teachers. And if I draw them out, I'll go help them decorate their classroom and give them a little check to buy classroom supplies, that type of stuff. I realized it turned out to be bigger than I thought it was. We had a little over 600 teachers. In fact, I had teachers sending in. I had one from Virginia. I had two from North Carolina, all over the state. And I had to go back on Facebook and tell them, say, hey, guys, this is for Horry County. Now, I'm doing this I'm doing this for our teachers. I mean, I love all teachers, but my teachers mean a lot to me. And
they came from both near and afar,
to participate.
Yeah,
that's right.
I wish I'd have had that word. I could have used that word in my vocabulary.
Well, feel free to use it from here on out. It's yours. I hope I don't have to hear it again. But you go right ahead and use that in your journeys.
I'll sure do that. But I did. I got a chance to get out there and work in the classrooms. And it was funny because it wound up being I had one middle school, St. James Middle, got selected, and I had four elementary schools. I had Carolina Forest, I had St. James, Carolina Forest, Midlands, Aynor, and my mind's a blank. Myrtle Beach Elementary was the other school. And I got a chance to go in and work with the teachers. And, I mean, I just had a great time. And I did everything from cutting out things and laminating.
You have the safety scissors?
I did.
You didn't run with them,
yeah,
did you?
No, I tried not to.
I never got that, man. Well, I always had trouble with the safety scissors.
Yeah. But, like I said, it was everything from that to I had one teacher when I got there, she literally had everything in a corner. I mean, nothing had been set up, and we had to take her desk and set them in place and do everything. When I walked out that afternoon, we had everything done and the bulletin board done. So
how about that?
But it's just a little way to give a little something back because, you know, our motto is inspiring possibilities. And I tell you what, it's a great thing. I'm real happy with the way things are going in the school district, and they've accepted me. I believe if you go to work every morning with a good frame of mind, it makes everybody around you feel the same way.
I agree.
Yeah.
When I come in here, you know, like a bear, it kind of impacts everybody.
Yeah,
doesn't it?
Yeah. It does. Yeah.
How does it work with you and the deacon? I mean, you know, I mean, did he keep you inspired?
Oh, he does.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. I look at him and I say, wow, I got some work to do before I get to be his age. So he inspires me, yeah.
He keeps me perspired.
Well, I hear you.
kind of an easy trade-off.
There. I was trying to think back of when Deacon was on the radio, and I remember that was back when I believe it, I was almost in high school back then.
Yeah.
And that was back when we were using ink wells.
It was. It was great.
Yeah, I remember playing football. I think we still wore leather helmets.
I think I've got a photo of you giving a high five to Marconi when y'all perfected that whole radio thing.
Heck yeah.
Pretty cool.
Well, I tell you what, guys, I it's great being here with y'all, and I really appreciate your support for education, because it's a big thing. A lot of people don't realize how much goes into it, and I had no idea especially when I used to be in business. I mean, I'm working harder now than I did then. It's nothing now to put in 75 to 80 hours a week. And then when I get off, it don't matter where I go, if you walk into somewhere and they know you, they're going to talk about a school, their child, or what's going on, or something that needs to be done. So, you know, it's just interesting.
Well, it is interesting. Education.
Yeah, it is. It is.
I didn't know.
Well, let's talk about the most important thing when it comes to school for me, lunch.
Yeah, right.
That's right.
Oh, gosh, yeah. Well, I tell you one thing. I'm happy to say we've got, you know, we're in a situation with most of our schools, you know, where the kids get breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
They get lunch, and I mean good lunches. Not that we didn't have good lunches back when I was in school, but it's just the choice today. I mean, there's a lot of input in making sure the kids get the right nutrition and that type of stuff. And it's a good thing. I think most of the kids enjoy lunch at school. And then, of course, you always got a few that bring a little something because, you know, some kids.
We used to pack our lunch.
Oh, yeah.
Peanut butter sandwiches. Now you can't do that anymore. If I'd have brought a peanut butter sandwich to school today. Yeah. Probably kill three kids or something.
Oh, because
in
of the peanut allergies and stuff. You got to be careful with all that. Allergies. Yeah.
Let me ask you this: Do you still have the cheese sticks? The infamous cheese sticks they used to put in the trays.
You know, I know they got the chicken fingers. And
that's new.
Yeah, I'm not really sure. It seems like, you know, when I go in for school visits, I'm always there first thing in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm almost never at a school during lunch.
Oh.
And yeah, you know, we got. You know, we got 54 to 56, 57 schools now,
mm-hmm.
and I was in 48 of them last year. And when you're trying to do two school visits, you know, every least two a week, when you're trying to do two a week, it gets it can get going pretty good.
Well, folks that are watching us early in the day, I'm sorry, Dick, go ahead with your point.
I was just going to say he needs to go in there and have breakfast with them one morning or something. You know, get your day started.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That's true.
Yeah,
that's true.
You could do that.
Look at all those choices.
Well, a lot of folks that are tuning in are going to be enduring school buses out there.
Right.
How many? I mean, do you know the number ballpark? How many school buses are out there on Horry County roads?
I'm not sure exactly on that. Jim, we got a guy, Jim Wright, that's over our transportation department.
Right.
Does a great job. Been at the school district, oh, gosh, probably over 30 years, I know.
Right.
And Jim does a great job. You know, we just got a bunch of new propane buses from the state.
You're a mind reader. Yeah. Yeah, propane buses, Deke. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
Propane buses. And propane accessories.
Yeah. Yeah,
don't start that, Jack.
At the last week of school, I kind of had kind of a funny thing. I called Dr. Maxey and I asked him. I said, "Listen, I said, Rick, I would like to, ride on one of these new propane school buses." And he said, "What do you mean ride?" He said, "You mean just take?" I said, "No, I want to go on a trip. I want to go do a tour with the kids."
Mm-hmm.
So I did, and I had a blast.
What's a propane bus?
Yeah, well, it doesn't. See, they don't run either on diesel or gasoline. They run on propane.
Yeah.
Well, that's convenient.
Yeah.
Well, the most convenient and the best thing about it is the state gave us these buses.
Yeah.
They give
you propane, or do you have to run down there to the service station and trade out of town?
Or get one of them little old...
Blue Rhino in.
All we had to do was just put in a propane filling station, and they bring us the propane and fill it up and furnish the buses. As a matter of fact, we got 22 new buses coming.
Wow.
That'll go with the other buses that we
have. I didn't know you were going to get that many.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
That's huge.
I've never heard of anything like that. Propane school buses.
Oh, yeah.
Well, the municipality's been using them for
they're quiet for a while. They're quiet and a lot quieter than a diesel bus. And of course, it got great air conditioning on them. And I got
air conditioned buses?
Well,
we can't have that. We didn't have that when I was young. I'm going to go out and give me a picket sign.
That's great.
Yeah, it is. It's a good thing. But there's a lot of good things happening in Horry County Schools. I mean, I'm proud to say we're the third largest district in the state, but I want to say we're the best.
We've got some blue ribbon schools, and we're doing pretty well on the testing.
Yeah, we are. In fact, all of our SAT testing went up last year.
That's awesome.
And we're putting STEM program in now, and pretty much all the schools it'll be in. And we just hired six new ESOL teachers, you know, for our different Spanish or different languages that we use in the schools. So it's been a great thing.
An exciting time.
Yes, sir. Yes,
now,
sir.
Now, here's a guy who's in the car business, now in education. Now,
well, I bet you got to be good at math.
That's right. So you already had your math down, right?
Well, I try to have it down. Yeah. I miscalculate every now and then.
Well, let me ask you this. What's your favorite? Between those two professions? I mean, you're quite,
education, without a doubt.
Yeah, because you're quite the sales guy.
The thing about it is, it's like planting a seed. You never know when every child I meet, I never know what they're going to grow up to be. I mean,
they thought they knew I was going to grow up to be a convict.
Yeah.
No.
Oh yeah.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Well, I've heard some stories.
Well, I tell you, you never know when you see a kid and you talk to them a little bit, it might be that they're going to be the next senator, or either they're going to be the next president of the United States. You never know.
It can happen.
It sure can.
It can happen. Man, I am glad you took time out of
I appreciate
first
you guys.
Day.
Good, man. It's good to see you again.
Glad to be here.
Ken Richardson.
You guys make a good team. I enjoy it.
Horry County School Board Chairman.
Yeah. Thank
enjoy
you.
Your day.
I'm going to sure try to. Thank
maybe
you.
Maybe we could get him to come in here with some safety scissors, some construction paper, and help us decorate this. We could do like a theme every month.
Well, I would like to. I'd like the old cigar box with the pencils and stuff in it. Remember those? Maybe I'll incorporate that into the
school. I'll tell you what. You know what we did with the cigar boxes? What's we made that? Guitars out of ours. I might have to bring one. Yeah, play the cigar box guitar one day. Who knows? Hey, come on back. Yeah, I'm just double checking to make sure we got everything. The Oaks. We're back into the whole groove here. Let's check out this feature and see what they're up to at the Oaks.
Hi, I'm Christy Massey, Executive Director here at Inlet Oaks Assisted Living Community. I started my career in healthcare while in college at a local pharmacy. I earned my degree as a medical laboratory technician and moved into earning an additional degree in nuclear medicine. After working a number of years in the hospital, I felt a desire to do more. I moved into a career working in hospice where I quickly realized where my heart belonged. That's when I knew that working in long-term healthcare was my calling. Getting to work in hospice was one of the most meaningful careers. Helping families when they are at their most vulnerable point is a true calling. For me, I wanted to get to know the families long before that time was near. To get to be there when they still want to be as independent as life will allow them, while also being a hand to hold when they can't. Getting to know the residents and their families is something I look forward to every day. The residents here are not just people that need help, they are family. They know every morning I make my rounds just to check on them and get my daily smile. They know I have a strict open door policy and that they can come to me at any time. I'm here to help make them feel that this is truly a place to call home. The strength of Inlet Oaks comes from its dedicated associate. Every associate is a personal representative of Inlet Oaks to the residents and the families that we serve. Our mutual goal must be to provide the highest caliber of resident care at all times. Here at Inlet Oaks, we offer you our warmest welcome. We aim to provide a safe and secure environment to meet your ever-changing needs.
Achieve the smile you've always dreamed of with the Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry. Let Dr. Jeff Horowitz and his staff use their expertise to improve your health as well as your smile. From TMJ or bite problems to smile makeovers, implants, gum disease, and even braces and Invisalign, let our team show you the difference of true comprehensive care. Call today to set up an appointment. The Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry, with two locations to serve you better, one in Conway and Murrells Inlet, now accepting new patients.
Anderson Oaks has turned out to be a home away from home for my dad.
The staff here treats the patient as well as the family with dignity and respect.
I think that the rates here are reasonable.
They got to go stay somewhere. They need a better place to stay than this one.
And Anderson Oaks is just making me so fond of life in general, and I just can't wait to get up in the morning and say, God, what do you want me to do today?
I'm Johnny Gardner. I was born and raised here in Horry County. I went to Coastal Carolina, and I
I've been practicing law here for 25 years. I've seen this county grow, new roads, more cars, and unfortunately more car wrecks. If you or a loved one have been injured in a car wreck, give me a call. It won't cost you anything to see if I can help. You take care of getting better, we'll take care of the rest.
You wear many hats, and HTC knows what you need to keep the day running smoothly. You're an entertainment coordinator, appointment maker, and business superhero. You're a personal chef, chauffeur extraordinaire, and a trusted protector. No matter where life takes you, HTC keeps you connected by bringing world-class technology right here to Horry and Georgetown counties, because you are here, and so are we. HTC, this is life. Connect with it.
Hey guys, I'm John Cassidy with Duplicates Inc. and Market Smart, the best printing company in the area, and we're right back to RiverTalk 2.0.
Hey, it's that time for the part of the show where we get to salute someone who does incredible things in our community. Brought to you by Philanthropist.com.
Today we celebrate philanthropy. Food where there was hunger. Homes where there was abandon. A dancer dances. A student soars. Music replaces silence. A garden flourishes. A community unites. The future takes root. Plans are made, opportunities taken, and dreams come true. All made possible by the power of philanthropy. In September of 2018, Hurricane Florence dropped 13 trillion gallons of water over the Carolinas and Virginia. For 2 weeks after the storm, floodwaters continued to rise, eventually flooding over 2,000 homes across Horry County in South Carolina. The Rosewood area of Sauchestie was one of the hardest hit. At its worst, floodwaters nearly reached the roofs of several Rosewood homes. John Schaefer, pastor of Discover Church in Surfside Beach, South Carolina, worked with his congregation to be a lifeline to meet the physical, financial, and spiritual needs of this community before and, more importantly, after this record-breaking natural disaster.
I grabbed my associate pastor at the time, Mitchell Atkins, and I said, "Hey man, come ride with me for a little bit. We're going to just walk through a neighborhood." So we did, and we met him down there, and we just started taking out boxes. And literally the first house I went to was a guy. He and his wife were out there trying to do sandbags, and the wife couldn't help him much, and it was hot at this time. It was super hot, and I just never hardly got past that. They kept walking down the road, and I'm just helping this guy do sandbags, and you know, I just felt the Lord speak to me of, you know, you need to help these people. They, you know, where would Jesus be in this county if he were here right now? He would be where this storm's going to hit. And that's how it all started. It just all started with those sandbags at that one house before the storm came. The visual of devastation after we had been in there for a week or so every day, helping people get their appliances out and get everything out of their house, and just walking around on dry ground, and then to go back in and see that we couldn't even drive even close to where we were. That was immediate, just overwhelming feeling of, you know, we know these people now. We had met a lot of people in there and built relationships with them, and to just, for it to really sink in, I mean, we knew a storm was coming, but we were so busy renting U-Hauls for people, buying storage units for people to put their stuff in, and so we were busy. But when we just went, and that water is just sitting there, and there's no, and it's like a ghost town, that was overwhelming.
Strangers met because of the decision to lend a helping hand. Strangers became friends. Friends became family.
I had sandbags on my truck. I was leaving. I had already sent everybody home. It was dark, and I knew that the water was going to be in the next day. This was going to be our last night we could really be in there. And before I left, I was going home, and I remembered I had like 40 sandbags left on my truck. And I'm just like, okay, God, I know somebody needs these sandbags, and you're going to have to show them to me, because if I get to this stop sign, I'm going home. I'm tired. I'm going home. So So I'm going down White Pine Drive. I see Tamiga standing in her driveway. I'd been seeing her off and on, but you know, they had everything in a big pod that was sitting in their driveway. And I just said, hey, y'all okay? You need some sandbags? She was like, yeah, we could use some in the back. Next thing I know, I come around to get bags out of my truck and there's like six guys helping me. And I'm going, oh man. So we go on. So when we get all the bags put at her back door, we're standing in her front yard. And we introduce each other, and I say, hey, I'm John Schaefer. I pastor Discover Church in Surfside, small church, you know, or whatever. And then the guy just stands there, and he says, oh, my God, I cannot even believe this. Like, he just had chill bumps. He made everybody look at his arm. And I'm like, well, how do I know? I don't think I know you. He goes, yeah, you do. I said, no, I don't think I know you. And he said, we spoke on the phone about a week ago. I'm the friend of Grady Jeffrey, so we end up at the same driveway at the same exact time before the storm. So the kicker is, we start talking, and he said, when I heard your name, I knew God was gonna do something amazing. He said, my best friend was named John Schaefer, and he died 2 months ago in North Carolina. His dog got in a fast-moving river, and he jumped in after him. They went over a waterfall. The same guy that my other friend had read about the month before and called me and said we had read that John Schaefer had died. We were making sure it wasn't you. That's how I met Tamiga.
He's awesome. I couldn't thank him enough. I couldn't thank Discovery Church enough. They have done so much. It's just amazing. When he sticks by somebody, he sticks by them. And he's been with me every step of the way. Every step of the way. I'll tell anybody about him. He's awesome. He is awesome.
The long-term solution to this devastating event was the almost total rebuilding of the surviving homes. This grew into a six-month commitment.
We can't do this. This is bigger than us. This is crazy. We'll just do one. We'll start with one house. We'll rebuild one house. And once we started with that one, it was just amazing what God did and how he brought us another one. And every time he brought us another one, the resources came with it. Out of the blue, churches we'd never heard of in the upstate, a lot of word got out on Facebook what we were doing. There were a lot of, you know, little quick videos of we're in this house, we're in that house. And next thing we knew, people were resourcing us. We were getting checks in at the church from churches we'd never heard of. There was one church in Georgia in particular where a 10-year-old girl was watching it on the news and saw it and everything. And they're right over the Georgia line. And she went to her church leaders and said, you know, why aren't we doing anything to help those people? You know, and I talked to the leaders later and they were like, well, because, you know, that's in Myrtle Beach. And then like, well, because, and they really couldn't come up with a good because. And because of this 10-year-old girl, they made a trip down here and rode with us to see what all we were doing and what the devastation was. Small church. They went back and did a huge fundraiser and brought us a big check. And we even had that 10-year-old girl to come in and we recognized her at church. But it was awesome how God used a 10-year-old girl to engage a whole church that's not even in our state to come in and invest in rebuilding Rosewood. It really wasn't anything I did. It really wasn't even anything Discover Church did. It was so much bigger. There were so many churches that resourced us to buy sheetrock and insulation and flooring and you know, it wasn't that we did anything great. We just did what was there for us to do.
God drives him. He's a true believer. He's a firm believer. He always wants to help. He's just a hands-on person, and I think that's nothing but God. You know, God put people in your life for reasons, and John is a great guy. He's somebody you would definitely want on your side, because he won't leave you. Whenever you're in a need, he's the one that you can definitely count on. He will drop everything to help someone else. His daughter was in a situation. He was there for his daughter, but he still made sure we were fine. He called and checked on us. We called and checked on him. Even at his daughter's side, he still wanted to see what he could do for me. So John Schaefer is, he's heaven sent. Heaven sent.
Today, we celebrate philanthropy.
My family keeps me on the go. And as fellow community members, HTC believes friends and neighbors deserve services that keep the day running smoothly. No matter where life takes me, HTC keeps me connected by providing world-class technology to Horry and Georgetown counties. Because you are here, and so are we.
HTC, this is life. Connect with it.
I'm Johnny Gardner. I was born and raised here in Horry County. I went to Coastal Carolina, and I've been practicing law here for 25 years. I've seen this county grow, new roads, more cars, and unfortunately, more car wrecks. If you or a loved one have been injured in a car wreck, give me a call. It won't cost you anything to see if I can help. You take care of getting better, we'll take care of the rest.
Anderson Oaks has turned out to be a home away from home for my dad.
The staff here treats the patient as well as the family with dignity and respect.
I think that the rates here are reasonable.
They got to go stay somewhere. They need a better place to stay than this one.
And Anderson Oaks is just making me so fond of life in general, and I just can't wait to get up in the morning and say, God, what do you want me to do today?
So your credit score is less than perfect, say 550 to 660, and you think you need to go to one of those payday lenders to get the money you need.
At Anderson Brothers Bank, we make loans other banks won't, at rates finance companies can't touch.
If you're in need of a small loan to help consolidate debt or a larger auto loan for your next car, we can handle that.
Walk into any of our 23 locations and walk out with the loan that you need within minutes, or apply at abbank.com.
And try one of our 20 cold brews, and now we're back to RiverTalk 2.0.
Hey, welcome back to RiverTalk 2.0. We just keep right on rolling down that highway paved by Southern Asphalt. Let's jump on the phone. You ready, Deacon?
Oh, it's Mr. Johnny is with us again.
Is that what you're calling him
that
now?
I call him
Mr. Chairman.
Well, yeah. Well, to me, he's Mr. Johnny.
Johnny Gardner from Horry County Council, the chairman over there. How are you, Johnny?
Hey, how's everybody? I'm doing great. How are y'all?
I'm doing quite well. I saw you there at the light at King's, Bypass 17 and 62nd Avenue. I believe you were driving a Jeep the other day.
Yes, yes, yes. Probably going to work and to work real hard at the county council.
Yeah, going to work and going to work real hard. I'm a self-starter. I love to get up in the morning and go do the job because I work for myself. I don't have to please anybody. I don't have anybody coming down on me. So my morale is pretty high. But back when you were out there running for county council chair, hard to believe that it seems like so many moons ago. But morale was one of those things that popped up when you were discussing, your run with county employees.
Yeah, it was a big part of it. In fact, that's why I got in it. There was morale and some pay issues and things of that sort. And at times it has flown by. You know, it doesn't seem like it's, you know, we're into, what is this, August already?
Yeah.
So, yeah, time has flown by. And it was important for me. We ran a campaign on public safety being priority. We wanted to take care of our county employees as well as our first responders. And we've been able to do some things like that. You know, we passed a budget that we were able to give the county employees a raise, first responders a raise, morale. You know, there's always room for improvement. That's what makes this county a great county. We're always looking to better ourselves. But right now, morale is much better than it was a year ago or before I got involved in it. And it's just a different mindset with council, I believe. We're trying to, and it's not all about money. The employees will tell you it's about a feeling, and I think that they've got a positive feeling that they know that the county council cares for them, is looking out for them. An example of that is for sick leave, donating sick leave to co-employees. That was a policy that was in place before I was there, and it was terminated before I became on council, and there was some abuses as was cited as a reason for canceling it.
Mm-hmm.
And at our last meeting, we've enacted it. It's a compromise in, to allow it for special occasions or for special needs, if you will. And that helps the employees, and it also helps the people looking at it, that they'll know it's not being abused or it's not being wasteful. That's going to be supervised by our county administrator. And for example, if an employee was injured, could not work, and he did not have any sick time, he was out of sick time or paid time off, and he had a co-employee that wanted to donate some for him, then the county administrator would approve if he looked like it was necessary, and he would approve that, and everybody wins. So that's a good thing for the employees. Another thing that we're looking at, we're going to try to do some type of outing for them. We talked about something at Coastal. We may look at something different, kicking around some kind of cookout or adventure or something for these employees. This is an employee appreciation day, and we're going to have that this fall sometime.
Okay. Yeah, so to be determined. Okay, well, that's
neat. To be determined.
That's neat.
Yes.
Well, if I was getting up watching this show, that boosts my morale right there.
Oh, yeah, especially if you work for the county.
Yeah.
You know, so I think it's little things help people. They know that you're thinking about them and trying to make their day a little bit easier. So we're moving forward. You know, there's excellence in our county motto. So we want to look at that every day and move forward.
All right, my friend. Well, I appreciate you taking time out of that busy schedule. I know it's busy for spending a little time with us today. We appreciate you, Johnny Gardner.
I appreciate y'all. Thank you for calling. Y'all
absolutely.
Have a good day.
Sure enough. Johnny Gardner, Horry County Council Chair. Don't go anywhere. You coming back, Deacon?
I'll be here.
I'll
right
be
here.
Back. Hopefully you will, too. Stay tuned.
This is Delaney with Moonshadow Studios, and I thought that you would like to meet the real Moonshadow. Say hey, Shadow. We'll be right back with more RiverTalk 2.0.
You can be approved.
At Anderson Brothers Bank, your options are endless. With loans starting at $1,000, we can get you approved even if you have a low credit score. Still nervous about applying for a loan? Anderson Brothers Bank ranked third on the Forbes list for in-state banks. So give us a chance to show you how we treat you like family. Anderson Brothers Bank, since 1933.
Anderson Oaks has turned out to be a home away from home for my dad.
The staff here treats the patient as well as the family with dignity and respect.
I think that the rates here are reasonable.
They got to go stay somewhere. They need a better place to stay than this one.
And Anderson Oaks, it just makes me so fond of life in general, and I just can't wait to get up in the morning and say, God, what do you want me to do today?
I'm Johnny Gardner. I was born and raised here in Horry County. I went to Coastal Carolina, and I've been practicing law here for 25 years. I've seen this county grow, new roads, more cars, and unfortunately, more car wrecks. If you or a loved one have been injured in a car wreck, give me a call. It won't cost you anything to see if I can help. You take care of getting better, we'll take care of the rest.
Achieve the smile you've always dreamed of with the Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry. Let Dr. Jeff Horowitz and his staff use their expertise to improve your health as well as your smile. From TMJ or bite problems to smile makeovers, implants, gum disease, and even braces and Invisalign, let our team show you the difference of true comprehensive care. Call today to set up an appointment. The Carolina Center for Advanced Dentistry, with two locations to serve you better, one in Conway and Murrells Inlet, now accepting new patients.
You wear many hats, and HTC knows what you need to keep the day running smoothly. You're an entertainment coordinator, appointment maker, and business superhero. You're a personal chef, chauffeur extraordinaire, and a trusted protector. No matter where life takes you, HTC keeps you connected by bringing world-class technology right here to Horry and Georgetown counties, because you are here, and so are we.
HTC, this is life. Connect with it.
Hey guys, I'm John Cassidy with Duplicates Inc. and Market Smart, the best printing company in the area. And we're right back to RiverTalk 2.0.
Hey, you're still here? That's good, because it's that portion of the show that Deacon really gets a kick out of.
No, I sure do.
Being a Coast Guard man.
Daggone right, buddy. Semper Paratus. Yeah. Always ready.
Always ready.
Yes, sir, buddy.
The Oaks Veteran of the Week.
Yeah, and you know, getting old sucks. Like, every time
Alternative.
Well, it is, but I agree with that. Yeah. But I got to keep using these glasses, these reading glasses.
Is that like a magnet that puts those together?
Yes, it does. That's pretty cool.
Do they jump off your head when you walk by the fridge?
You know how you be goofing around or something, you lean down or whatever, and they go falling off. Well, this right, they'll break away, so you don't have to keep buying the glass. I've had these things for a few years.
Wow.
Yeah, they work. They work great.
But you used to have a pair of breakaway pants, didn't you, back in your dancing days?
Yeah. Yeah, we won't get into that. breakaway Sansa belts. Our veteran of the week is Rochester Gilchrist. Rochester Gilchrist, they called him Rock. He's from Mullen, South Carolina, served during the Vietnam War as a sergeant in the U.S. Army. Rock served for 3 years. After his service, Rock became a physical education instructor in Washington, D.C.
Wow.
He now resides at the Anderson Oaks in Conway.
Okay.
Yep. So congratulations, hats off, and a salute to Rochester Gilchrist, better known as Rock. Thank you, buddy.
The Rock.
Yes, sir. Nice guy. Real nice fella.
Cooking. I'm sorry, I had a WWF moment. It's WWE now.
WWE. Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, Vince McMahon's going to be doing that XFL. If you do a little search on your favorite search engine out there on that interweb. It'll take you to the XFL, and they got a countdown clock. I know we're getting ready for, like, college football and the NFL all that. Yeah, and I'm excited about what they're going to do with the XFL, Vince McMahon.
But I'm just really into football.
You can do it year-round now, it's beginning to look like.
Yeah, I'm loving it, man. I can't wait. This is
you do season. Fantasy football?
Fantasy football, I haven't seen that yet. What are they doing, fantasy football?
Have you been under a rock?
I have been. How's that work, fantasy football?
Well, you
kind of
like put together like a virtual team.
Now I know what you're
talking about. Are you with me now?
Yeah, right. You take different players from different teams or whatever, some of the better
ones.
A little competition going on, fantasy.
Right.
You put the running backs, your favorite running back, quarterbacks, not all together, all the best players, and you play other people.
Yeah.
I'm not that totally stupid.
I bet Andrew does that. I mean, because he's a Ravens fan, so he's got to do something with football to win.
Oh, yeah.
Do you, Andrew?
I used to do it all the time through college and then work, but I haven't done it the past 2 years because if you've ever done
it... Well, you're married now. There's a lot of things you're not going to do that are fun.
That's right. Yeah.
Well, it takes up so much time. You find yourself reading all these articles.
Who says it takes up too much time? That's your wife talking.
It's different fantasizing.
Oh, it takes up too much time.
Yeah, what's wrong with you, buddy?
Yeah, I can hear Andrew hold my hand. Andrew walk with me. Andrew kiss my mouth.
Kiss my mouth.
Walk the dog. Yeah, come on. Yeah. It takes so much time. Good Lord. And he's only a year and 2 months and 1 week and 3 days and 17 hours into his... Yeah, I count.
56 seconds.
Oh, man.
Oh, me. Too much time. We got to go. Because, this show's taking too much of Andrew's time. Walk the dog. We'll see you soon.
Doodles.